This is an introduction to the basic operations on binary heaps in well under 10 minutes. Binary heaps are rooted binary tree structures with two special properties. The first property is the shape of the heap. It's going to be a perfectly balanced binary tree where every non-leaf has exactly two children and all the leaves are at the same level, gives us this great shape. Well, it gives us that perfect shape if we happen to have exactly the right number of nodes to make a perfectly balanced binary tree. Instead, we can have an arbitrary node where the last nodes are going to be filled in on the bottom from the left. This is called a complete tree. And notice, when we have an even number of nodes, 32 in this case, we do have one node which has only one child instead of two children. But once we insert another node, now we're back up to an odd number of total nodes, 33 in this case, every non-leaf has exactly two children. We can fill in as many nodes as we want. We're always filling in from the left on the lowest level, and we get this nice shape. That's the entire parent-child structure of the heap. But it doesn't really give a great impression of the heap's shape because, well, every level of the heap has twice as many nodes as the level above it. So if you want a more accurate intuition for what the shape of the heap should be, it's more like... By the power of Asgard! Okay, so that gives us the full structure and shape of the heap. The next thing that we're going to talk about is called the heap property. To discuss the heap property, we're going to actually have to look at some values in the tree. So a heap is an abstract data type, you can store whatever you like, but for our purposes, we're just going to look at it with some integer keys. Now, the heap property says any node has a value at least as large as the value in that node's children. So 90 is at least as large as 89 and 70. In this case, 89, the left child, happens to be bigger than 70, the right child. That property is going to happen throughout the heap. So if we look at 89, 89 is a node, and its value is at least as large as the values in its children, 36 and 75. In this case, 75 happens to be the right child and it's bigger than the left child. There's no left-right orientation of which is larger in the heap. Also notice 75, even though it's on a lower level of the heap, has a larger value than 70. That can happen as long as 75 is not a direct descendant of 70. Now, that's the second property. And notice, if we have those two properties together, we get something nice. Every node is actually the root of its own subheap. Has the right shape, has the right values, everything's nice. Next thing we're going to need to talk about is the heap representation. So the shape of a heap is so regular that we can really represent it nicely. We know, for instance, that every heap with 10 nodes has exactly the shape of this heap, and that the 10th node is the left child of the right child of the left child of the root. So what we're going to do is we're going to use an array to store all of our heap values. We're going to store them top to bottom, left to right, and there, we know, in this case, the 10th value is going to be the 10th value in the heap. We're going to use the indices of our array. It's called our implicit heap description. The indices of the array to describe the parent-child structure. If, for instance, we're indexing from 1, then the left child of index I is at 2i, and the right child is 1 past that. Or the left child of 3 is at 6, the right child is at 7. If we're indexing from 0, we're going to be set off 1 from there. Okay, finding the maximum node is going to be the easiest operation we have because BAM! There it is! It's right in the first place, right in the root. First spot of the array, can't go wrong. Easiest operation there is. The next operation I'm going to talk about is insertion. It's probably not the most important operation, but it's really easy. We know what the shape of the heap has to be after you insert, so we're just going to insert a value there. And if we happen to insert this value, let's say 12, and it's smaller than its parent node, we're done. Well, what happens if we insert a larger value, like 72? Well, 72 compares to its parent. It's bigger than its parent. They swap. Compares to its new parent, 70. It's bigger than that, so they swap. Compares to the root, in this case, 90. It's not bigger than 90. We're done. Just keeps on moving up until we're done. One other thing that we can do, let's say we insert a 70. Well, 70 ties with its parent. No need to continue. Done. That's insertion. How about deletion? Well, if we want to delete the last leaf, great. We just get rid of it. There's nothing else to do. But that's a really weird operation because there's nothing special about the last leaf. Basically, it's an easy thing to do, but there's not much of a reason to do it. Much more likely, we want to delete the root. The root is a special value. This is a max heap. The root is the maximum value. So what we're going to do is we're going to take that root. We're going to swap it with the last leaf. And now, delete the last leaf, which we know is so easy. Now everything looks great. We have these two subheaps and a node up there which might have not have the right value. This is actually an operation called MaxHeapify, or it has other names and other depending on what book you're using. But this is probably the most critical operation for a heap. We have two perfect heaps and a node above them that gives the correct overall heap shape, but that top node might have a value which isn't larger than the value of its children, which is the case here. So in this case, we compare it to the left child. The left child is bigger. So we're going to compare the left child to the right child because we want to know which child is larger. The left child's larger. We're going to swap the root with its left child in this case. Now we're going to compare that node. Well, everything looks good except its subtrees. So we're going to compare it to its left. The node itself is bigger. So we're going to compare it to its right child. The right child is bigger in this case, so again, we're going to swap that. Now we compare the node to each of its children. The left child, it's bigger. Compare the node to its right child, it's the biggest value. Stop. Great. Let's do one more example there. This time, I won't draw the subheaps as we go. So we're going to swap 12 up to the root. 12 compares to the left. The left is bigger. The left compares to the right. The left is still bigger. We swap down to the left. Then we compare to the left. The left is larger. Then we compare the left to the right. The right is larger. We swap down to the right. Now we're going to compare 12 to its one and only child, 15. 15 is bigger. So we're going to do that last swap and we finish because now we're in a leaf position. Finally, let's talk about efficiency. Finding the max value, very easy, constant time. To do insertion, assuming that we have enough room at the end of our array to just put a value there in constant time, well, for each level of the tree, we might have to do one comparison and one swap up to the height of the tree. That's logarithmic time. To do deletion, well, we start off with a swap. Then, for each level that a node might go down, we're going to have two comparisons, maybe, and one swap. Again, logarithmic in time. This is the longest of the Intro to Heaps videos. There's going to be four of them, maybe. Next one's going to talk about building a heap in worst-case linear time. Then we're going to have heap sort. Then we're going to have some other operations that you might want to use heaps for priority queues. There will also be a few more advanced heap videos. Please watch them. Anyway, I'm late for my colonoscopy. I have to go now.